Hello, thanks for joining me, astrologer Patrick Arundel, for your in-depth horoscope forecast for week commencing the 19th of August for the Sun or the Ascendant. If you've yet to subscribe to my channel, I'd be grateful if you did so now. This week begins with a shift of emphasis beginning to take shape. Late last week, Mars, the planet of drive, moved into the sign of Virgo. Now, this is a bit counterintuitive because Mars is about the individual. It's about our desire to get instant gratification. It's a more masculine energy. Of course, Virgo is the virgin. It is about sacrifice and purity. But Mars in this area can see us able to work harder, sustain our efforts in a much more focused way, and look for tangible results. Now, Mars is going to be joined on Wednesday by Venus. Now, Venus in the sign of Virgo is also quite self-sacrificing. And then they're both joined on Friday by the Sun, which returns to Virgo for the first time in 11 months. Now, in the last phase of this week, the three are going to be together. So we have a stellium. And this is going to be fascinating because they're also going to be linking to Uranus in the sign of Taurus. So we have this greater emphasis on the things that require our attention to detail and where we need to be thorough and precise and discriminating, which all comes from that Virgo energy. But there's also a push to be creative, inventive, and a bit spontaneous, which is coming from the energy from Uranus. Also, as we enter into this week, we still have the backdrop of last week's Venus-infused full moon, which occurred in the sign of Aquarius. So we were already being asked to juggle our priorities and manage our time, especially in a social or romantic context. So I think what this Virgo energy is going to ask us to do is really focus. And the interesting thing also is there is a quarter moon on Friday in the sign of Gemini, which could see us tempted, because of the Virgo energy, to almost be too virtuous and to try to pack in so much at the end of this week that we actually end up spreading ourselves too thinly. So really prioritizing on what's really important is going to be really helpful. And the other thing that's happening this week is that Mercury, now it's going forwards in the sign of Leo, is actually forging a superb angle to Jupiter. So Jupiter, of course, is in Sagittarius itself going forwards. So if there is a scheme which requires us to think big, be positive, but apply ourselves in a very precise way, which is supported by this Virgo energy, well, we're certainly getting it all together. But it's important to understand that the stellium between the Sun and Venus also links with Mars, and that's quite a sultry combination. So it may see us orientated in some way with our passions to do something that can be good for someone or good for a relationship, but especially where we can think of another person's needs and be a bit more thoughtful or practical in the way that we help them. Your specific forecast, Gemini, shows that your communicational skills, which are such a gift to you, are going to continue to be very important this week. This is because the full moon, which occurred last week, is still bringing its energy to bear right through this week too. But the emphasis is changing. We're moving from a time when ideas and philosophies and everyday sparkling chat and banter may have been a big part of what's been going on. And you're now going to be focusing your attention and your communications more towards the base of your existence. So that means the people who really mean a lot to you. That can be family, it can be extended family, it can be the friends that you treasure. You can be thinking more closely about where you live, how you live there. Redecoration may appeal, or you may want to make some physical changes. Scale up, scale down. But what's interesting is some of the decisions you start to be drawn to make could come from a spring deep within you and come up into your consciousness in quite a surprising way. If this does happen, the main thing to bear in mind is to listen to your hunches. Sometimes, because you have got such a mercurial nature, you like to process everything through your intellect. And you can do that to great effect this week because your ruler is forging a dazzling alliance with Jupiter, which may see you have a fab connection to someone romantically or someone who gets where you're coming from in terms of the things that really enthuse you. But at the root of all of it, whoever you're attracted towards, do listen to your gut feeling, because it could be quite surprising some of the instincts or prompts that come up from deep within you. If you'd like to know more about personal astrology based on your time, date and place of birth, which is a world beyond just your zodiac sign, why not check out the link beneath this video and visit my personal horoscope store. You can buy a 12-month forecast and a character analysis, and I will give you a 30% discount. Or if you'd like, you can choose to book a personal consultation with me. But for now, it's been a real pleasure being with you. Good luck and goodbye.